students, so now today we are going to start our half hour of the exercise 9.2. let's start from question number 6. is it okay? so now today we are going to discuss continued proportion. okay ji, so now first let's take a question. if 4x and 9 are in continued proportion, okay, are in continued proportion. continued proportion means this number, center number, is repeats 2 times. so let's write 4:x is equal to x:9. is it okay? so now you people write here 4 by x by 9. okay, and your question is this: find value of x. so we people find x square is equal to 9 times 36. okay, so x square means 6, it should be written. so x is equal to 6. this is your answer. clear to you? next one is, next one is, show that the following numbers are in continued proportion. okay, show 48 60 and 75. these numbers are in continued proportion. continued proportion means in the sense, if you have to take, you have to repeat of the center part with the ratio. okay, what you find that you have write this 48:60, 60:75. this number is a continuously repeat. okay, so 48 by 60 and 60 by 75. okay, what would you have? 4 by 5, this one. okay, so what we need, 4 by 5 is equal to 4 by 5. it means 48, 60 and 75, these are in continued proportion. is it clear to you? same as we are going to do the rest of the questions, that will be also same of that one concept. okay students, so now see exercise 9.3. in exercise 9.3, this is on a unitary method. questions are like this: if cost of 1 kg, cost of 12 kg rice is 150, and find the cost of 20 kg rice. okay, these questions are like a unitary method, we should do it. suppose that your question is, if the cost of 30 m cloth, okay, 30 m cloth cost is, suppose that 150 rupees. okay, this is the cost of 30 m cloth. and now you people find, okay, what is your question? find cost of 12 m cloth. okay, so what do you do? 30 m cloth cost is 150. 1 m cost is 150 by 30, and 12 m cost is 150 by 30 multiplied by 12. okay students, so cut this. 3 × 1 = 3, 3 × 4 = 12, 15 × 4 = 16. it means 12 m cost is 60 rupees. clear to you? so same as students, you have to do another one question. I am going to take, yes, the statement is this. suppose that, yes, the price of the cost of 17 chairs, okay,
yes, cost of 17 chairs.
Okay, what is the cost of 17 chairs?
That is 9,605.
Okay, and he told you
if money is this rupees, how many chairs purchased? How many chairs?
Is it okay? Clear? Okay. How many chairs you have to purchase in 56,500 rupees? So,
yes. 9. This is the cost of 17 chairs. So, in 1 rupee, 7505.
Okay. And in
100, you have to find 7505 multiplied by.
Okay students, so now divide this number and get your answer. Your answer is behind this. You have to cut it properly and after that you find that firstly,
yes, divide by this one. Sorry, this one.
Okay, so now firstly
75 jump, 85, 1 0. After that 79 jump, calculate here and this is 85 and 5 jump. So sorry, 6 jump, this one. This is goes to 1765.
Okay,
and table of this one 100.
Is it okay?
So how many chairs in between this money purchase?
100 chairs. Is it okay, students? So thank you so much. Revise these questions.